Inshallah, before the Sheikh begins the lecture, I'll give a quick introduction on some basic things about the Sheikh. Imam Karim Abu Zayd. Karim Abu Zayd is the Imam of Colorado Muslim Society. He received the Master's in Usul al-Din, Fundamentals of Islam, Quranic and Science of Hadith at the American University in Alexandria, Virginia. He is currently a teacher and Imam at Muslim Society in Denver, Colorado. Inshallah, this is basic things about Sheikh. Farid Fadlak, Shkura Majuddin.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. My brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الموت. Death. There is a story in the Sunnah that is very famous, the story of the death of Prophet Musa عليه السلام. هي في صحيح البخاري من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, where very quickly Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent the angel of death to Prophet Musa عليه السلام. And Prophet Musa did not recognize that this is the angel of death, and he poked his eye. Then the angel of death went back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, you have sent me to someone who does not want to die. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the angel of death, go back to him and ask him to place his hand on the back of an animal, thawr, ox, and the number of pieces of hair that his hand covers, he gets to live 1 year. Imagine how many years. Just your hand covering how many pieces of hair. Each piece of hair, you get 1 year to live. That's a lot of years. So the angel of death went back to Prophet Musa alayhi salam and he told him, listen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you to place your hand on the back of the animal, the ox, and the number of pieces of hair that you cover, for each piece you get 1 year to live. Then Prophet Musa alayhi salam said to the angel of death, then what? Then the angel of death said to him, then you will die. Then Prophet Musa alayhi salam said to him, I'd rather do it now. So regardless of how long you live, you will die. It's a fact. And you cannot flee from death. You can't. You can't run away from death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually states in the Quran saying, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. Say to them, O Muhammad, the death that you flee off, it will meet you. Normally when you flee from something, you leave it behind you. So as you flee, it will face you. You cannot protect yourselves from it. You can't. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
قل لو كنتم في بروج مشيدة أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة. Wherever you are, death will overtake you. Even if you place yourselves in high fortified or elevated fortified fortress. You can't. If there is someone, somebody who really deserves to live and never die, would have been Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised his character. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have the best character. And at the same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٍ. You will die. وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. So, I'm not talking to you about death, because if we can prevent ourselves from death, I would have chosen another subject. But whether we like it or not, sooner or later, we have to face it. And the issue about death is it does not have a certain time. It's not like, okay, I'm 7 years old, that means I will be dying in 5 years. That doesn't work like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us every day, children, infants, young men, people at the age of 20, people at the age of 30 dying. Sometimes by all of a sudden. So there is no really a certain time that you could begin talking about it, because your end is approaching. You have to be constantly in a state of readiness. And this is something that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he touched the shoulder of Abdullah ibn Umar, كما في البخاري رضي الله عنهما, كن في الدنيا كأنك غريب أو عابر سبيل. Be in this dunya like a stranger, rather someone who is passing by. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma understood from the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said this, إِذَا أَمْسَيْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الصَّبَاحِ وَإِذَا أَصْبَحْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الْمَسَاءِ. If you are to live until the evening, don't hope too much to live until the morning. Don't wait. And if you are granted that morning, don't hope for the night. Brothers and sisters in Islam, as a matter of fact, it is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to talk about death. And unfortunately, in our cultures where we were brought up, when you talk about death, why are you being a pessimist? Talk about something else, please. Come on. Can you bring up a happy subject? Why? As a matter of fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in a straightforward command, wal hadith sahih al isnad, akthiru dhikra hadhi min ladhat al maut. Mention abundantly, or keep talking about it. Mention often, often mention the destroyer of all pleasures, death. As a matter of fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prescribed for us deeds which if we do, we get a lot of reward. But the reason behind its prescription is to remember death. You know when you pray janazah, how much you get of reward? Qirat. Hadith Abi Huraira fil Bukhari. Qirat. A chunk of reward. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked about this qirat, he said, a chunk of reward as big as the mountain of Uhud. Just to pray janazah on a deceased. And if you follow the janazah until it's buried, you get another chunk of reward. But of course, it has to be done sincerely for Allah, not because he came and he attended your relative janazah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually said, كنت قد نهيتكم عن زيارة القبور ألا فزوروها. Previously, I have banned you to visit the graveyards. People now, they think that they go to visit the graveyards because they want to benefit the deceased. Actually not. You could make dua for the deceased from your house, from the masjid. You don't have to go to the cemetery in order to make dua for the deceased. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not know who you're making dua for. Oh Allah, this is the person I'm making dua for right here. Here's the graveyard. طب هذا كلام ينفع؟ ما ينفع. No. Actually, you go to the graveyard, you go to the graveyard to remember that. كنت قد نهيتكم عن زيارة القبور ألا فزوروها فإنها تذكركم بالآخرة. Because it will remind you with death. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم also كما صح هذا الحديث زور المريض أعود المريض واتبع الجنائز فإنها تذكركم بالآخرة. Visit the sick, follow the janazas because it will remind you with the hereafter. So alhamdulillah, we are implementing the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and we are remembering death. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I have to bring this up that the reason behind the weakness of the Ummah is the fact that a lot of the Ummah became unaware of death. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث صحيح الإسناد في سنن أبي داود من حديث ثوبان رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, توشك أن تداعى عليكم الأمم كما تداعى الأكلة إلى قصعتها. Time will come when nations will group against you Muslims. They will invite one another against you Muslims. Like they do invite one another for a party or a meal. Then one of the companions asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أمن قلة نحن يومئذ يا رسول الله, because we are outnumbered, O Messenger of Allah. He said, no, بل أنتم يومئذ كثير. No, you're many. But your impact, ولكنكم غثاء كغثاء السيل. Your impact is like the foam. The foam of that white thing that you find in a running stream. You see that foam? White stuff. ولا ينزعن الله من صدور أعدائكم مهابتكم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will extract out of the hearts of your enemies your fear. They are not going to fear you anymore. ولا يقذفن في قلوبكم الوهن. And he will cast into your hearts a disease called الوهن. قالوا وما الوهن يا رسول الله. They said, what is الوهن, O Messenger of Allah? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, حب الدنيا وكراهية الموت. The love of the dunya and hating death. That brings up a question. What is meant here by hating death? Let me ask you this. Who does not hate death? You're naive if you say I don't. If you're naive if you say I do not hate death. As a matter of fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala In one hadith, he described his wali. حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه والحديث في صحيح الإمام البخاري قال صلى الله عليه وسلم the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said الله سبحانه وتعالى says من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Whoever have or has animosity against one of my أولياء ولي I will declare war against that person. Now you want to be the wali of Allah? You want to be the wali? Not wali. No, here is the curriculum right here. Number one. وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. You want to be the wali? You want to be the friend of Allah? Do you want to be the friend of Allah? Begin with that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made mandatory upon you. Don't tell me that you're a wali when you do not pray 5 times. Don't tell me you're a wali when you do not perform, give your zakah. Don't tell me that you're a wali when you do not fast. Don't tell me that you're a wali when you do not perform these acts according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You perfect the mandatory, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ. And my servant will continue doing voluntary deeds. Not just 5 prayers, he prays tahajjud at night. كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. More. Until I love him. Until Allah loves you. And if Allah loves you, فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتَ فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ. I will be his hearing. I will be his sight. I will be his hand. I will be his feet. شوف. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّهُ. And if he asked me, I will give him. وَلَئِنْ اسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأُعِيذَنَّهُ. And if he seeks refuge with me, I will give him the refuge. Look, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about this wali, at the end of the hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually said, my wali يَكْرَهُ الْمَوْتِ. He hates death. وَأَكْرَهُ مَسَاءَتَهُ. And has an eye, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is speaking, has an eye ordained upon my wali death. I would have spared him, but I said everyone shall die. But الشاهد is what? هذا ولي ويكره الموت. فكلنا يكره الموت. All of us, by the way, it's natural. هناك حديث أنا أعرف أنه صحيح الإسناد. الله سبحانه وتعالى at the beginning of time he said to the نفس يا نفس أخرجي. When Allah created the soul he said come out, you're gonna come out of that body. قالت يا رب لا أخرج إلا وأنا كارهة. I'm not gonna leave that body unless I'm hating to leave that body. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أخرجي وإن كرهتي وإن كرهتي. You're going to have to come out even if you're hating to come out. And by the way, you remember the story of Satan and Adam at the very beginning, Adam and Satan? Huh? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed Adam in a garden and he told him, eat from everything that you want, you and your wife Adam, except that tree. And remember, Satan is after you. You know, in order for Satan to get Adam in trouble, what did he say to him about this tree? قال يا آدم, O Adam, هل أدلك على شجرة الخلد. Shall I show you the tree
that if you eat off, it will protect you from death. You will never die. Death is something that is حتى للمؤمن. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما ذكر هذا الحديث وهو في البخاري، حديث عائشة وعبادة بن الصامت رضي الله عن الجميع، قال صلى الله عليه وسلم، the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says، من أحب لقاء الله أحب الله لقاءه، ومن كره لقاء الله كره الله لقاءه. If you love to meet Allah, Allah will love your meeting. Now, when are you going to meet Allah? Can you meet Allah in this dunya? I'm asking you, can you? Yes or no? Can you? Can you see Allah in the dunya? Huh? No, you're not confident about it. I want a confident answer. Can you see Allah in the dunya?
No.
No. Absolutely not. You cannot see Allah in the dunya. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول اعلموا، when Allah when he spoke about the Dajjal, because the Antichrist, and we're going to talk about the Antichrist tomorrow inshallah, when the Antichrist comes to this world, he's going to tell the people, what, I am your Lord, أنا ربكم, worship me, I am your Lord. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us اعلموا أنكم لن ترون ربكم حتى تموتوا. This is actually, his statement is a sign of his lying. Because you're not able to see Allah in this dunya. You're not going to be able to see Allah until you die. Unless you die. فعائشة رضي الله عنها, when she heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, whoever loves to meet Allah, Allah will love to meet him. She said, Ya رسول الله, ومن منا لا يكره الموت. Who amongst us does not hate death? We all hate death. قال is not death يا عائشة. He's not, that is not it يا عائشة. That is not it. No. But when the believer experiences death, he sees glad tidings, and at this time he loves to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the next 20 minutes or so, 20-30 minutes, inshallah, I would like to take you in a journey when it comes to the final moments of a living person. وهذا الحديث يعني ما أجمل هذا الحديث. How beautiful this hadith. What a beautiful hadith that we have in the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. حديث البراء بن عازب رضي الله عنهما. والحديث في مستدرك الإمام الحاكم. وقال على شرط مسلم. He said this hadith meets the requirement of الإمام مسلم. Beautiful story. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم and his companions rushed to the burial of one of الأنصار. The graveyard was not ready yet. اللحد, they were still digging. So Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم sat down and his companions sat around him. البراء بن عازب يقول كأن على رؤوسهم الطير. Because of the silence, birds would land, would fold, would land on their heads because they are so quiet. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم had a stick in his hand, a piece of stick, and he was poking the ground with it. You know when you're thinking. Then he said to his companions the following: استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر. استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر. استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر. Seek refuge with Allah from the punishment of the graveyard, in the graveyard, three times.
And then he started narrating. إن العبد المؤمن, the believer, إذا كان في انقطاع من الدنيا وإقبال على الآخرة, when his life is about to end and he's about to join the next world, his time is up, he's about to die. نزل إليه ملائكة من السماء. A group of angels will descend from the heavens. بيض الوجوه, bright in faces. كأن وجوههم الشمس. The brightness of their faces is almost like the brightness of the sun. معهم كفن من أكفان الجنة وحنوط من حنوط الجنة. They brought with them coffins, shrouds from paradise, and odors, scent يعني from paradise. فيجلسون من الميت مد بصري. They will sit in front of the person as far as his eyesight reaches. So he would be sitting right there and he is surrounded with his family members. He will be surrounded with his family members. But yet he is watching these angels. He's actually watching them. But the living are not aware. The dead person, by the way, goes through different things that you're not aware of. That is why you have to be so kind to them, because they are experiencing the world of the unseen. يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم made دعاء that شيطان does not mess with him at the time of death. شيطان actually could come to you at the time of death and mess with you. ولنا قصة. قصة موت الإمام أحمد رحمه الله. الإمام أحمد, when he was dying, his son Abdullah, he actually came to him and he said to him, Ya Abi, my father say لا إله إلا الله. He's asking his father to say لا إله إلا الله. His father was answering him by saying, not yet. الإمام أحمد هذا هو اللي راوي الحديث, من قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة, من كان آخر كلامنا الدنيا لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. He's the one who compiled in his musnad, whoever says whose last words is لا إله إلا الله will enter جنة, whoever whose last words in the dunya لا إله إلا الله will enter جنة. And here is his son asking him to say لا إله إلا الله, and he's telling to him not yet, not yet. So he lost his consciousness and he returned again. So his son Abdullah is asking him, Ya Abati, my father, I was asking you to say La ilaha illallah and you were telling me not yet. I became concerned. He said, Ya Bunay, my son, I was not speaking to you. I was speaking to Shaytan, Satan. Satan came to me and he said, Falatta minni ya Ahmad. You escaped from me, Ahmad. I was unable to get to you, Ahmed. You see, Satan sometimes comes to you from the window of giving you a big head. So Imam Ahmed would think that, okay, he's in control now. I said, no, not yet. Not yet. I'm still hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guard me against you. Not yet. Not yet. فالشاهد, or the important thing here, that those who are experiencing death, they see the world of the unseen. They begin seeing angels, and so you need to be careful. So these angels will sit right there in front of them and they see them. فيجلسون منهم مد البصر. Now when the 0 minute is here, the time to leave then the actual angel of death will descend, will come. You see, these angels, by the way, they are called the assistants to the angel of death. But they are not the angels who extract the soul. No. Malakul Maut is that angel who extract the soul. And amongst a lot of Muslims, they call him Azrael. They gave him the name Azrael. ما ورد هذا الاسم في سنة صحيحة. Don't ever name him Azrael because it never been mentioned in an authentic hadith. His name, Malakul Maut, the angel of death. You will find people saying Azrael. ما ورد هذا. Where did you get that name from? Yeah, a fabricated hadith. But authentic hadith, ما ورد. Malakul Maut. قل يتوفاكم Malakul Maut. For the angel of death will descend. And he will sit next to the head of the person who's about to die. Now remember, I said maybe 10 minutes ago that the soul does not want to leave the body. Remember, I said that you hate death, even if you are a believer. Therefore, you need help to get that soul out of the body. And you know who will help you if you're a believer? The angel of death. You know who will help you? The angels who are assistants to the angel of death. And this is what is meant by this verse, الحفاظ في سورة فصلت. إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا. Those who said our Lord is Allah, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. Not just lip service. ثم استقاموا and they were steadfast. 5 daily prayers, paying the zakah, fasting, no haram, no adultery, no drugs, no marijuana, no smoking, no all of that, enjoining good, forbidding evil. Straight. No one is perfect. But at least you're striving. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Look. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ يقول ابن عباس. Angels will descend upon them. يقول ابن عباس. ابن عباس. ترجمان القرآن. He says, these angels will descend upon them at the time of death. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا. Don't be afraid of us. Don't be afraid of death. Don't be afraid of me. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Don't grieve over your family, over your friends. Don't worry about them. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ. I want you to think about Jannah now. Jannah. Detach yourself from this world. Leave this world. Think about Jannah. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. I want to think about Jannah. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. By the way, we were guarding you in the dunya and we'll be with you also in the hereafter. الْآخِرَةِ, the hereafter. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا. And in the hereafter, مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. Think about the hereafter. So glad tidings. Glad tidings. I don't know if we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all of you strong health. But have you been to a surgery? Have you been through a surgery? Before you go through the surgery, they send you anesthesia group. The anesthesia provider will come to you,
I'm the anesthesiologist, whatever it is, and we're going to give you a shot, very simple shot, and then you're going to go to sleep. After that, the doctor is going to do the surgery. Things are going to be just fine, okay? You're not going to feel anything. That's exactly what these angels are telling that person. Don't worry about it. It will be okay. We're going to take your soul out easy. And you're going to Jannah. As soon as he hears this, the soul leaves the body like what? A drop of water from a water bottle or whatever you want to call it. Not only this, by the way, as the soul is extracted, as the soul is taken out of the body, these angels will keep repeating this. أيتها النفس الطيبة, O good soul, dwelt in a good body, in a pure body, come out to the pleasure of Allah. Come out to what awaits you. And they will keep repeating this until the soul leaves the body. Add to this, if this person, brothers and sisters in Islam, was somebody who was keen on attending the salah, the masjid, all his friends are people who follow the Quran and Sunnah, are people who are devoted to the deen of Allah. His family will be aware of the Sunnah. They will actually also ask him to say La ilaha illallah at the time of death. And if he says La ilaha illallah at the time of death, this will also help him die. The soul leaves the body. As soon as the soul comes out, these angels right away will grab it from the hand of the angel of death. Place it in that shroud from Jannah. And that soul will smell so beautiful. That smell actually will be smelt by angels between the heavens and the earth. And they will say, what a beautiful soul this is. Who is this person? Who is this person? And then they will ascend with that soul to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very easy process for a believer. What about someone who was wicked? What about someone who cared less about this? What about somebody who would hear this stuff and yet he laughs? Even so, we're talking about death. This is a sign of a heart that does not absorb, sealed, needs a lot of cleansing. وَأَمَّا الْعَبْدُ الْفَاجِرُ وَأَمَّا الْعَبْدُ الْكَافِرُ وَأَمَّا عَدُوُّ اللَّهِ. As for the wicked person, the disobedient, the one who cared less, the one who is not mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he's about to die, angels will also descend. But this time, scary angels, intimidating angels. And they will also sit in front of him, and they brought with them a shroud for the soul, but from the hellfire, made out of fire. They will sit right in front of him. He will see them. As soon as he sees them, he knows that is not a good end at all. He will actually begin being afraid of what to come. Then the angel of death will come and sit
next to his head. When it's time to extract that soul out of the body. And look how the angel of death will call that soul, brothers and sisters in Islam. Remember, the angel of death called the soul of a believer, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةُ. O pure, good soul, كَانَتْ فِي الْجَسَدِ الطَّيِّبِ, dwelt in a good body. Come out to the pleasure of Allah. Look at the soul of a disobedient, the soul of the enemy of Allah, the soul of a kafir. أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْخَبِيثَةُ. O wicked soul, never prayed 5 times. Never believed in Allah. Lied all the time. Cheated all the time. Gossiped all the time. Drinking alcohol. Smoking marijuana. Dope. Drugs. Wicked soul. Dwelt in a wicked body. Come out to the anger and to the wrath of Allah. As soon as the soul hears this, it will be scared and it will escape into the body. You know what they have to do to get it out? Beat that person up.
وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذْ يَتَوَفَّى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْمَلَائِكَةِ يَضْرِبُونَ وُجُوهَهُمْ وَأَدْبَارَهُمْ وَذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقِ فَكَيْفَ إِذَا تَوَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَضْرِبُونَ وُجُوهَهُمْ وَأَدْبَارَهُمْ وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي غَمَرَاتِ الْمَوْتِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بَاسِطُوا أَيْدِيهِمْ أَخْرِجُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ الْيَوْمَ تُجْزَوْنَ عَذَابَ الْهُونِ.
Beating that person. Beating that person up. Get that soul out. Come on. Get the soul out. The soul is skating in the body. The soul doesn't want to leave. And this is, by the way, what is meant by the statement that I shared with you earlier. مَنْ أَحَبَّ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَهُ وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ كَرِهَ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَهُ. The soul doesn't want to meet Allah. Because the soul is concerned. This is just the beginning. These scary angels is just the beginning. What to come is greater. The soul then hates to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But yet, they have to take the soul out. As they take it out, it will burst the soul, the veins of the person. So difficult. Then as soon as the soul leaves the body, brothers and sisters in Islam, it will stink. And the angels actually between earth and heavens will smell that stink. What an awful smell this is. Remember, the soul of the believer ascended to Allah, the seventh heaven. The soul of the kafir, the disobedient, will not even enter the first heaven.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا عَنْهَا لَا تُفَتَّحُ لَهُمْ أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاءِ وَلَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَاطِ.
Only in one case that the soul of that individual will ascend to Allah and enter Jannah. When you're able to put through the eye of a needle a camel. Impossible. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I would like to conclude here the first session talking about death, and I will have another session after Maghrib inshallah. But in 10 minutes or so, or maybe less, very important because we talk about death to learn something. Why the soul of the believer was called O pure good soul? And why the soul of the disbeliever was called O wicked soul? Was the disbeliever, was the disobedient, was he given a wicked soul to begin with? The answer is no. Both the believer and the disbeliever, the righteous and the wicked, both of them were given the same exact type of soul. You see, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, كما في حديث ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه في صحيح الإمام مسلم, that when we become 120 days in the womb of the mother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the angel of the souls to blow the soul in that piece of flesh. So each one of us was handed, was given a soul. But here is the condition of that soul. A soul that is ready to go to wickedness, and a soul that is ready to go to righteousness. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. And by the soul and the one who perfected it, فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Both. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. You see, your job and my job is to purify that soul, is to keep it pure, clean. So when the angel of death comes to you, he finds it clean and pure. So he will call it out, O clean, righteous, pure soul. How do you do this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down the curriculum for you. Al-manhaj, the Quran and the Sunnah. That's how you purify your soul. Every time you pray, you have purified your soul. Every time you fast, you have purified your soul. Every time you speak the truth, you have purified your soul. Every time you refrain from gossiping, backbiting, you have kept your soul clean. That's how you do it. You implement the religion in your lives. If you do this, your soul will always be clean, pure. So when the angel of death comes down to extract it out of your body, he will say, O good soul, come out. But the person who did not do it, he neglected his soul. Brothers and sisters in Islam, he will see the result of that negligence right at the bed of death, when he sees these intimidating, scaring angels coming to take his soul. And I want to remind you, all what we said is an explanation of a beautiful surah that I'm almost positive that a lot of you memorize it. والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها. All of this, by the way, is oath. قسم. Oath. The longest oath in the Quran. The longest oath. The longest oath in the book of Allah is on this issue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا, by the sun. والقمر إذا تلاها by the moon والنهار إذا جلاها and by the daylight والليل إذا يغشاها by the night والسماء وما بناها and by the heavens والأرض وما طحاها by the earth ونفس وما سواها and by the soul and the one who fashioned it فألهمها فجورها وتقواها He made your soul ready to go to wickedness, to righteousness. And he placed inside you the freedom of choice. It's up to you. If you go and smoke marijuana and do drugs, that's fine. Go ahead. But remember, you're polluting that soul. It's going to be a wicked soul. At the time of death. Meaning they will have to beat you up to take it out of your body. You have the freedom of choice. If you don't want to pray, nobody's going to come and please come and pray. No. But every time you do not pray, you're polluting that soul. You're affecting that soul. Remember, you have the freedom to choose. But at the end, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا Successful indeed is the one who worked hard. Strove. Yes, Fajr at 4 o'clock in the morning. I'm going to wake up to purify my soul. Yes, I'm going to wake up and pray. Yes, 5 daily prayers is difficult in America to pray. Yes, I'm going to do it. But a successful قد أفلح and a loser is someone who failed to purify that soul. It's up to you. It's your soul. It's your end. But don't go far away. The Quran and the Sunnah بفه سلف الأمة is the way to go. That's the curriculum. If you want to purify your soul, implement the Quran and the Sunnah based on the understanding of the 3 virtuous generations. With this, brothers and sisters in Islam, I have concluded my first session about death. Don't miss the next session as we will talk inshallah about the graveyard and the fitna of the graveyard and how the graveyard will turn to be a garden from the gardens of paradise or a bit from the bits of the hellfire. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته خلاص أبشر كده خلاص